I was always very interested in motion. When I was a child and my father used to drive the car too fast, and I would say, "Go like the wind, Daddy." You know, and he would drive really fast, which was a bad idea. But it's like that. It's like that kind of motion is elemental. It's a kind of manila rope. It's very large, and it's used as hauling line. And I spliced the ends so that there are loops at both ends, which in something that hauls something else, there has to be a loop so that, you know, the thing can be attached and moved. And that way it's an imitation of an actual thing. I've just gone overboard with the lengths of the ropes and how I've hung the ropes and whether they were on the floor or suspended from the ceiling. Those are all things that happened as a result of putting it in a gallery as opposed to attaching it to a boat. A lot of times when my work has allusions to things that are outside of its physical self, I think that that has to do with the way that symbol and metaphor can work in literature.
It does seem like it's floating, doesn't it? Because it's moving a little bit, I think.
My performance practice in LA was a continuation of this desire to be a dancer. I had entered Bennington College trying to be a dance major. They said, "No dance major for you." But I never like quite forgot about the dance training, and I did a lot of performances that were based on movement. The best I could do was to be a visual artist who did performance, and that was the closest I could become to being a dancer. Untitled 1972 was actually an experiment for me. I was trying to understand what it meant to splice rope and how that splicing could be used in an evocative or poetic sort of way. So I went down to the docks in San Pedro, and I met a man who said that he would be able to help me with this splicing. And I tried to explain that it would be for a fine arts project. And he was actually quite kind to me. He didn't think I was crazy, and he did the job beautifully. And I'm forever grateful, and I just hope I thanked him enough. The original piece was hanging on a loading dock, which was fairly narrow.
See, this, there was a loading dock in the middle. This was on one side.
Okay. With a wall.
With a wall and this much loading dock. And this was on the other side, see? Mm-hmm. This is the hole in the floor, I guess, over here.
I think I decided to add more ropes because there was more space involved. So I wanted to make sure that the number of pieces I made controlled the area. So I made more pieces.
Well, I'm glad we decided to expand it to fill the space. It looks like it's supposed to be here now.
I think that the sense of motion is there in the way that it kind of loops through the space. Motion is life. It signifies life. When I gave birth to my daughter, I was awake for the birth. That was intentional. And I saw the umbilical cord, and it looked like wire rope. There was this outer membrane, and then there was this inner, like, coil. And it reminded me so much of the thing that wire rope does. And at the time when I saw it, I thought to myself, oh, that's good. I'm on the right track. So that's all I can say about that. That's pretty elemental.